We're going to write each exponential expression in expanded form and then evaluate. When something is written in exponential form, we have a base. In this case, the base is 5. And the small raised number here is the exponent. The exponent tells us how many factors of the base we're multiplying together. So 5 to the second power, or 5 squared in expanded form, is 5 times 5. Notice how we have 2 factors of 5 because the exponent is 2. And we have factors of 5 because the base is 5. And 5 times 5 is equal to 25. Next we have 4 to the third power, or 4 cubed. The base is 4 and the exponent is 3, so we're multiplying 3 factors of 4. Well, 4 times 4 is 16. 16 times 4 is 64. Next we have 3 to the fourth power, or just 3 to the fourth. Because the exponent is 4, we'll be multiplying 4 factors of 3, or 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. Well, 3 times 3 is 9, times 3 is 27, times 3 is 81. Now in the next example, notice how the base is negative 3, so we'll have 4 factors of negative 3, so negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3. Well, we do have an even number of negatives, so this product will be positive. And then 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, as we saw above, is just 81. And then for the last example, our base is 2x. So we'll have 5 factors of 2x. And now we'll multiply. Notice how we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 factors of 2, and since 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is 32, and then for the factors of x, we'll just have to write this as x to the fifth. If you have difficulty seeing how I got this, remember you can think of 2x as 2 times x. And because all this is connected by multiplication, and multiplication is commutative, we could change the order of these factors. We could write this as 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 5 factors of x. In this form, it's probably a lot easier to see that here's the 32 from the 5 factors of 2, and here's the x to the fifth from the 5 factors of x. I hope you found this helpful.